Tonight, a 32-year-old man is fighting for his life after suffering a brutal attack downtown in broad daylight. Now, police say at this point it appears that the beating was unprovoked. 11 News reporter Kerry Cavanaugh is live downtown. She has the very latest. Kerry?
John Mason's family tells us he moved to Baltimore with his girlfriend because they love the idea of city living. Now he's in a medically induced coma at shock trauma, fighting for his life after suffering a violent attack near his home. John Mason moved to Baltimore 10 months ago and embraced downtown living, according to his aunt, Christina Jassy. She says the tattoo artist and his girlfriend established a laid-back lifestyle at their Cathedral Street home.
They lived what they called a boring life. They would work, come home, eat dinner together, walk the dog, go to bed.
A midday attack shattered that routine last Friday. Police say Mason was walking near Howard and Lombard Street downtown when four men converged and started beating and kicking him. Jassy says Mason was rushed to shock trauma with skull fractures, where surgeons noted footprints on his face.
It's a life or death matter at this point. We don't know if he's going to survive. And if he survives, is he going to have a quality of life where he can live by himself again? Will he need us to take care of him? We don't know.
Police say the attack appears to be unprovoked, but they are running down every possibility.
We're going to look into the victim's background to see if there might have been a dispute in his past that could have led to something. But right now, there's just nothing evident for investigators.
They also expect crime cameras to flesh out vague witness descriptions of four black male attackers.
What's good is the downtown area is pretty saturated with the Baltimore Police City Watch cameras. So we're hopeful that this incident might have been captured on tape. We're also talking to the people that called 911 to originally report it, trying to get a better witness description.
Mason's family is shocked that something like this could happen in the middle of the day in the busy downtown hotel and business district.
He was out running the errand that afternoon. He did not do anything to provoke this. And what we would like is for the people who did this to him to be caught so that they cannot do it to anyone else.
And of course, police are looking for any and all tips about the four black male suspects in this case. Meanwhile, Mason's family is keeping a vigil at shock trauma, where he is listed in critical condition. Reporting live downtown, I'm Kerry Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.